Welcome to the Cognitive Psychology, Learning and Memory lesson on Cognitive Psychology. By the end of the video, you will learn about research methods in cognitive psychology, early thoughts of thinking and cognition in the Renaissance and beyond. You will also learn about cognitive psychology in early 20th century and cognitive psychology as it is today. Cognitive psychology is all about understanding how we think. It's the study of how we perceive, learn, remember, and reason. Think of it as a journey into our minds to figure out how we make decisions and behave. Cognitive psychologists use experiments, case studies, and observations to explore these complex mental processes. Attention is a big part of cognitive psychology. Imagine your attention as a spotlight. It focuses on specific things and ignores distractions. This helps us process information and make decisions. Cognitive psychologists study attention through experiments to understand how we focus and concentrate. Memory is crucial in our cognitive system. We have sensory memory, short-term memory, and long-term memory. Sensory memory holds information briefly, short-term memory stores it temporarily, and long-term memory keeps it for a long time. Cognitive psychologists study these processes to understand how we remember things and why we sometimes forget. Perception is how we make sense of the world. It's not just about seeing or hearing, but interpreting these sensory inputs. Cognitive psychologists study perception to understand how we transform sensations into meaningful experiences. They look at things like optical illusions and depth perception to learn more about how we perceive the world. Language is a key part of cognition. It shapes how we think and communicate. Cognitive psychologists study how we learn, understand, and use language. They want to know how our brains process language and how it affects our thinking. Thinking and problem solving involve using and integrating information to reach goals and solve problems. It requires creativity and existing knowledge. Cognitive psychologists study how we make decisions and solve problems to understand these processes better. Cognitive neuroscience combines psychology and neuroscience to understand how our brain processes affect our thinking. Using tools like fMRI and PET scans, cognitive neuroscientists study brain activity during cognitive tasks to uncover how our brain supports our thinking. Cognitive development looks at how our thinking abilities change from infancy to adulthood. This includes how we develop language, problem-solving skills, and abstract reasoning. Developmental psychologists study these changes to inform educational practices and support cognitive development. Technology, especially AI and machine learning, is transforming cognitive psychology. AI can simulate human thinking and help us understand cognitive processes through computational models. This technology is helping cognitive psychologists study complex mental processes and innovate in education, healthcare, and technology. Cognitive psychology helps us understand how we perceive, think, learn, and remember. This knowledge improves our lives by informing education, healthcare, and technology. By understanding cognition, we can enhance cognitive functions and improve our quality of life. That's it for now. For additional information on this lesson, please look at the content below the video in the online course. To get a list of the important questions and their answers for this lesson, please refer to the guidebook by our publications provided to you with this course for free. It shows you a list of all the questions that have the highest chance of coming in your next exams based on research carried out on previous year question papers. All the best, and I'll see you in the next lesson.